Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be dipping on my shorties, but before that I thought it would be cool to share with you my very first Zooty order. Zooty, I don't know if I said that correctly. Anyway, so if you are new to the dipping community, Zooty is like a very sought after brand. And I was really lucky. I happened to be on the Facebook page. I think it was on like Labor Day weekend, and the owner of Zooty did a live. And then the way that it works is like you look out for the lives on her Facebook page, and then after she does the live, she releases the colors on her website and they sell out in like minutes. So I was really lucky to get the four colors that I wanted out of her Chemical X collection, and I thought it would be cool to swatch them and then do a mani with them. So that's what I'm doing here. So I got the Zooty Chemical X purple, pink, teal, and yellow. So I'm going to swatch each one of them, and I do kind of speed through the boring parts of me just putting base liquid on each swatch and then dipping them in. I end up doing three dips of each color on the swatches, as you will see. So this is my first round of each color, and they're really pretty. They're kind of like a matte glitter, so they're like white and like a color, the little like white dots. It was really a fun mani, and it was a really fun mani to dip on my shorties because it just, they were so cute. So as you watch me do this, I just want to thank you for being here. If you are returning, welcome back. And if you're here for the first time, welcome. My name is Stacy, and I like to do dip nails and designs on nails, and I like wine. So I like to include a picture of the wine that I had shortly after the mani that I did. And just a little bit of information so you know a little bit more about the wine, what it tastes like, where it came from, what grapes it is, and then if you ever want to try it, you will know a little bit about it. So here I am just doing the second layer and just kind of speeding through, doing a lot of nail magic here except for when I'm showing you the color. These colors did pick up pretty nicely on the camera, so they are pretty true to what color they are. And that cute little stand that I'm putting the swatches into, that came from Candi skincare. She has them, and I think you can find them on Amazon, but I did get mine from her, and it just makes swatching so much easier. Because I don't know about you, but there has been many a time when I've just swatched over like a paper towel, and then you put the swatch down on the paper towel and then the paper towel gets stuck to the swatch. It's just so annoying. So this makes it a lot easier. You can just have the swatches be standing upright until you need them, and then you can see everything as well. So it's really pretty. After two, it's probably good after two. I just wanted to have a third, because I was gonna do three layers on my nail, which you will also see. So here I am finishing this up. I will let you watch as I finish this, and then I will be back after I've done the gel top coat on these. right, so I'm back, and here are the colors. This is after 3 dips in the color and a gel top coat. I didn't buff the swatches or anything like that. And there was the purple, this is the teal. They're all so pretty and they look really cute together. This is the pink, and then the last one is the yellow. And then for my mani, I decide to do the purple and the teal, and I'm gonna be using my Triple D liquids. I did the purple and the teal because I felt like they were the most like fallish colors and I wanted more of like a fallish mani, but really all the colors would look pretty together in a mani at some point. So I left the colors in the cupcake liners because I thought that it would be best to lay my finger in the colors because they were kind of like not chunky but they were like particles, so it just was easier to lay flat into the colors. And I don't have any peel base on my nails or anything like that. This was just kind of like a in between mani where I wanted to just dip on my natural nails, let them grow out a little bit, and then soak off. So my Triple D liquids are awesome. They're definitely my favorite. It's actually a toss-up between Triple D and Vivid Dips at this point. I did try a new liquid yesterday for my mani, and that review will be out, I guess, next week. And it did give me pretty bad dip flu, so I kind of sound a little congested. I knew it. As soon as I opened the liquids and I saw the consistency and I smelled them, I was like, this is not going to be good. But it's okay. For each his own. So here is the Triple D liquids, though. They don't give me dip flu. Neither do the Vivid Dip liquids, and actually I can also use Sparkle & Co. and I can use Double Dip, so those are kind of like my go-to. And I sometimes like to torture myself and use new liquids and see what happens. So I do also have a few other reviews to do where I will review some other liquids. I recently also got Mama Makes Her Own Dips, and her liquids didn't give me dip flu either. I'm noticing that the thinner consistency liquids who have low odor don't really give me dip flu, but if something is a little bit thicker with more of an odor, that typically does give me dip flu. So that's basically it. If you get dip flu, let me know and let me know what liquids you can use. I know a lot of people are like, try the gel method. I just haven't yet. But I probably should. I'm actually getting in the Sparkle & Co. sub bag for September. The gel top coat is the liquid, and I got the gel base last time, so I should do a Sparkle & Co. mani with the gel liquids and see if that helps with the dip flu. So look for that. I will give that a whirl. So I really like the way these colors are going on. They're so cute with like the white specks in there. And I go in and I do, this is the first coat, I end up doing 3. So I will nail magic through a bunch of the other applications in terms of like the second coat and the third coat, because it's just very repetitive. So one thing I did leave in this video, though, is I did leave in filing and e-filing. So you'll see that on all my nails. I thought it was an easy manicure to do that with because there wasn't that much going on with it. I don't actually even clear cap these. That's why I was doing the 3 layers, because I thought without a clear cap, I just wanted it to be a little bit thicker and I wanted to make sure all the coverage was there. So you'll see me go through, dip again, and then I'll be back when I'm ready to e-file so you can see what I do. right, so I'm back. I went ahead and activated all my nails and I did my right hand, and now I'm ready for some filing. So I'm starting with the sidewalls, especially with this color because it's a little bit thicker, I would say. You know, I wanted to just clean up the edges and make sure that they were smooth and that they were the way that I like them. So I'm just cleaning up my thumb, and then I'll also clean up my pointer finger. I find that it's easier to use the finger stand for all of my fingers except my thumb, because then it kind of like stabilizes my hand a little bit better. And the file that I'm using is a McCart 100-180. I typically use the 180 side of the file only. I might use the 100 side for like scraping off some gel polish or something like that, but I pretty much use the 180 side for the most part. And now I actually cut out the rest of the just hand filing on the rest of my nails, but I do leave in the e-filing. So I'm using this bit that I got on Amazon. It's like a rainbow bit and it's got a rounded edge so I can get really close to my cuticle and not cut myself. And then I'm really just, what I'm trying to do is go around the edges of the nail, and then I just kind of do one smoothing motion. And going around the edges of the nail, what it does is it just thins out the area around my cuticle. And I think that that helps with not getting lifting. And then here I am just kind of smoothing out the rest, and then I'll go ahead and buff. So I don't really do a lot for each nail. Like that's typically all that I do, go around the edges and then smooth it around. And I do like to use my finger stand for that sometimes as well. But you can see here, you know, where I'm focusing the e-file, it's really just around the edges of my nail to clean them up a little bit. Because sometimes there's like a little ledge there, and I'm also like blending that in to the outsides of my nail. So I'm using my e-file that I got from iGel Beauty. I got it when they had their 60% off sale. And I'm pretty comfortable with using the e-file with my dominant hand, so I have it on an 8. When I'm doing the e-file with my non-dominant hand, I usually leave it around like a 6 or a 7, and I'm just going around each nail. The other thing that I will mention, if you've been watching like e-file videos, typically with e-files you're only supposed to go in one direction. So if you're using your right hand, you put it in the forward position and you're only supposed to go, you know, where it's going against the way that it's spinning. You will see me go in both directions, but that's really just when I'm trying to smooth it out. When you go in both directions, you run the risk of the file like looping around your finger. I don't know if anyone's ever experienced that, but it's because you're going in the wrong direction. It doesn't hurt and it's not a big deal, so I just do what I feel like is right. I'm by far not a professional at all whatsoever, but that's just what I feel is right for me. So now I'm getting into the wine that I selected for this mani. This wine is really special for me. The label has a Frenchie on it, like you just saw, and it looks just like my dog Buddha, who I lost in May. He had pancreatic cancer. It's been the most heartbreaking experience of my life. So the label looks just like him when he was a baby. The wine is from a region in the south of France near the Mediterranean coast called Languedoc-Roussanne. And basically, the wine online is described as minerally with honeysuckle, peaches, and herbs. But I think it reminds me of lavender. It was a lot more floral for me. And the wine is called Les Chiens, which means the dogs, which is really cute. The blend of grapes for this wine is 70% Roussanne, 15% Grenache Blanc, and 15% Field Blend. And the vintage is 2019. And we got it from Splash Wines. I do highly recommend it. It was really delicious, very floral, and it was very refreshing. So after I went ahead and did my e-file, I then buffed off camera, and then I already put the top coat on my right hand, and now I'm showing you the top coat on my left hand, I sped through the first coat, and then this is the more detailed second coat. You can see it's turning out really cute. I really did just love this mani. It was adorable and it was fun. So this is where I am right now, and I'm gonna let that dry and come back with my cuticle oil. The cuticle oil I'm using today is Pumpkin Pecan Waffle from Candi Skincare. It is like the best fall scent. It's so yummy and I love it. So I'm just gonna finish off with the cuticle oil, and you'll see a picture of the final result. And thank you so much for watching. I hope you have a wonderful day.